One concept that I see messing up new programmers all the time is void pointers. They've just begun to understand pointers, and then this new type shows up that they really can't use correctly, and it just messes everything up. My name is O-Level Learning. I teach people how to write faster and safer code, and today we're gonna talk about what a void pointer is, why they exist, and how to deal with them. Let's jump right in. First, we have to talk about pointers in general. What are pointers? So pointers are actually really simple, despite how often they confuse new programmers. A pointer is just a variable that contains the address of another variable. So for example, if we have a variable int a that is an integer variable, we'll say that its value is equal to 4. So now that value a contains 4 bytes that represent the number 4. So later on in the code, we can say that int star pa, that means that we have now a variable that points to an integer, it is an integer pointer, we can say that it contains the address of A. So now we can say that PA points to A. Now, I get a lot of questions like, why do we even use pointers? And in the case that we use integers like this, where I'm pointing a pointer to an integer, that's actually a very good question. We don't really need to use pointers here because the size of an integer is 4 bytes. And that's actually within the word size of our architecture. And because I'm on a 64-bit machine, that's 8 bytes. So this 4-byte type can actually just get passed around by value. I can make a function called int do a thing and it takes int x and I can return, you know, x plus 2, right? I don't need to do anything special with pointers because I can pass a by value. I can literally pass in a equals do a thing on a and that will add, you know, 2 to a will be 6. But what if we wanted to use values that were bigger? What if we wanted to use variables that were bigger than the word size, something that wasn't an integer? So instead of using a 4-byte value like an integer, what if I made a structure that is greater than the word size, greater than 8 bytes? And here I've made a structure called person that has 68 bytes of data. It has a 4-byte integer ID and it has a 64-byte buffer for its name, for example. So if I wanted to do any operations on person P, I'd have to pass P by reference. I could not pass it by value. And the way we would handle that is we would make a function that's called, you know, do a thing, only now it takes a person pointer. We'll call it P person. And we can say that inside this function, P person ID equals 0 or something. And then maybe we mem set the address of P person name 64 bytes or 20 of 64 bytes, right? Maybe this is like our initialize of person structure. Because person is such a large structure, we have to pass it by reference. And the way that we do that to call the function is we say do a thing on P. Awesome. So that's pretty straightforward. And then we can check the return value, you know, int ret equals do a thing. And obviously this would return some status code and we'll say return 0 for here. So then we've talked about pointers for a minute now. Now, what does a void pointer, the whole point of this video, what does a void pointer do for us? So when you actually have a pointer and you have, let's go back to our int a example, and we have int star PA is the address of A. If I wanted to dereference or look up the value at an address, I would add a star character, which is the dereference operator, which tells the computer to go to that address and get the value that lives there. Well, the question is, how much data do we get? We need to go get the value at an address, but a lot of structures are bigger than just 1 byte. Like I said before, the int value is actually 4 bytes wide. So by dereferencing the type, I use the type information that's defined at compile time to tell the computer how far out to go. And the reason this is so problematic with the void pointer, it is because the void type does not have a size. Because of that, if I say that void pointer, we'll call it VA, is equal to the address of A, I'm actually unable to dereference VA. And we'll compile this real quick and I'll show you that. So I get an error here, invalid use of void expression. The reason is the compiler is trying to make an assembly instruction to reach out to the address that's contained in our pointer variable and go get that many bytes. But the problem is it's a void type. It does not know how many bytes to get. So then you're probably wondering, why does this variable type even exist? Like, why would we create a type that does not have type information? It breaks all of our code, we can't use it. When we use functions that give us memory or free memory, memory allocation functions like malloc, for example, all of these pass around a void star as a type, right? So malloc returns a void star, calloc, realloc, realloc array, all use the void star type. And also when you free, you pass in a void star type. The reason for all of this is because the C language is giving you the power to tell the compiler what type is stored there. So let's kind of go through that in a practical example. So let's say I wanted to make room on the heap for my person structure, because right now my person structure is all being contained on the stack. Let's delete all this. And I say that I have a person pointer, right? So it's a person pointer. We'll call it P person. And I want to malloc it from the heap. And how big do I malloc? That's the input to malloc, right? Is the size that I'm getting. I'm going to malloc the size of a person. Well, by default, the equal sign will throw a warning. And if you have W error enabled, this will actually be an error because the malloc type is returning a void star and we are implicitly casting it to a P person type. So what we actually have to do is tell the compiler, hey, I'm aware this returns a void star type, but I need to convert it to a P person type. All we're going to say is a person star. And by putting it in parentheses like this with just a type, we're doing what's called a typecast. So the type that comes out of this is being converted at compile time to a person star and put into our variable. And then obviously we have to check our value, right? If we say if null double equals P person, then we say, you know, puts the heap failed. Run away or whatever. And then we return -1 because the program failed. We can't use our code here. And then if we want to later on in the code free it, we then free P person. And this does take a void star as input, but the implicit cast here is actually okay. And don't forget when you're using the heap, you also have to include standard lib because that's the library that contains those functions. And there we go. So now we've compiled the pointers program with no errors. So when is it a good idea to use a void star? Well, a void star is meant to represent what is referred to as typeless memory, right? So if you are mallocing from the heap or you have a variable that is undefined in its type, but just represents a raw blob of memory, that's where the void pointer makes the most sense. And then the minute that you know the type of that variable, you should then be casting it to that type or just use that type in general. Like for example, because this function is a, you know, let's say that this is the initialize person function, right? There's never we should never be passing a void star pointer and then saying person P person equals person star of pointer, right? Like if we know the type of the memory ahead of time, a person star of pointer, if we know the type of the memory ahead of time, we should never be using void star. We should always include type information in our code as often as possible. But in cases like this, where we are mallocing and freeing raw memory that is not known by the allocator at the time to include the type information, then we just use the void star the way it's intended and then cast it when we get that memory. Now, another question people typically have is why do header files exist? Like, why do I even have to include standard.io.h, standard.lib.h? And if you're curious about that, like I was, go watch this video, and go find out. See you guys there.